Hi, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm so glad that you found me. My name is Dr. Hempel. I'm also known as the Language Lady, and I am an English as a Second Language Specialist in the state of Pennsylvania. I teach 8th grade, and I've been teaching English as a Second Language learners for over 20 years. I post weekly videos on tips, strategies, and resources for ESL teachers across the globe. Today, I'm really excited to share with you an app that helps with reading writing skills and is called Padlet. I think you'll really enjoy this app, and I'm going to walk you through how to set it up for your classroom and just little tips and tricks that will allow you to set up a Padlet in a way that will be engaging for your students. If you're new to Padlet, Padlet is a great source for gathering, sharing, and modifying ideas to your students as well as among your students with each other. One of the wonderful things about Padlet is that you can upload links to educational websites, games, activities, worksheets. I mean, the choices are infinite, but they're all different types of choices that your students and different things you can expose to your students so that they're engaged in the activity. I'm gonna link everything in the description below so that you can follow along with me as I take you step by step through this tutorial. One thing I must mention is that you must already have either a Google account or G Suite for education, a Microsoft account, and also or an Apple account. If you don't already have a G Suite account for education, make sure you speak with an administrator to get the school set up so that your students are able to log in, join, and interact with the Padlet and join the specific Padlet that you have created for them. To begin with Padlet, you're going to go to the Padlet website and click on the pink link to sign up. As I mentioned before, you're going to log in with one of these accounts. Because I already have a Google account, I'm going to use that account. Once you're in Padlet, you have the choice whether to make a Padlet, join a Padlet, or choose from a series of templates that have already been created that you can also model your Padlets after and also to upgrade. Because under this type of Padlet that is free, the free version only gives you up to 3 Padlets. The upgrade version is $8.25 a month and will give you unlimited Padlets. In the case of this, I'm going to show you how to make a Padlet. There's 8 different styles of Padlet designs that I can use. In this case, I'm just going to click on the grid layout. And as you can see, it's already pre-populated with its own background, but I can change that later. And for example, let's say I'm going to be doing a Padlet on conjunctions. And I want them to hear a link or watch a link from a YouTube video, so I can just write an example of a description that I'm going to have them do. I can choose an icon. I don't have to. It's up to you if you want to do that. A lot of students do like that and they think that it's a lot of fun. Also, you can change the wallpaper design. There's solids. You have gradients. You also have textures and patterns. And then you also have pictures. For the sake of this, I'm just going to use the thanks teachers. And then I'm ready to start my Padlet. So what I do is I click on next and I can start posting. And remember, I can fill up this entire page with a plethora of information, or I can make it as simple as just linking one question, posting one question, and having students respond. When I began with Padlet, I didn't know how I wanted to start it and I didn't know what I wanted to look at. So one of the nice features is that there are template Padlets that you can model yours after, and you can even copy the actual post that they have within their Padlet. And then you can edit it once you bring that into the Padlet. So let me show you how to do that.
In order to take a template that's already been created and modify it for your use, you're going to click on Gallery, and then you're going to find a plethora of different templates that have already been created. For the instance of this activity that I'm doing on conjunctions for my students, I'm going to go ahead and choose this KWL chart, and then I'm going to click on Remake, And then because I want to copy not only the design, which is the background and the template, I also want to copy the posts so that I can edit them. Once I click submit, it's going to start remaking it in progress, and then it's going to direct it towards my Padlet, which I can actually edit. So one of the things I can do is I'll click on the pencil icon and I can change it. So I can say the conjunctions are the words but and or something like that. I mean, this is something that your students will fill out, what they want to know. And what's really nice is that they can see each other's responses and look at what each other thinks about conjunctions and then what they've learned. And it's a great tool that, again, fosters that collaboration, but it also lets you know what your students are aware in terms of whatever topic that you're touching upon that day.
I also mentioned earlier that you include clips and links and just allow your students to be able to be directed to other websites. So I'm going to use an example of a website that I use with my students and show you how you can include a clip or a link inside Padlet.
So in the case of the conjunctions, if I want to include a link to conjunctions, this is the conjunction song that I want. So I'm going to copy it. And I'm going to click on the link icon and click on the link and press save, and immediately they're going to be able to see the link to the song within that post. The other things that I can do is I can upload documents, files that I already have. I can also go to Google, and if I want to have a picture, let's say if I want a picture on conjunctions, I click on conjunctions and then it will show me different files that it automatically will appear. Another thing I can do is if I want to take a picture, maybe I want my camera, I want to say something to them or record myself with the directions that I want them to do, they'll be able to see that as well within the Padlet.
Please comment below any ideas that may be running through your mind already as how you think you would like to utilize Padlet in your classroom. And if you're already using Padlet, please share what are the fun activities that your students really enjoyed, perhaps what template you liked, and what type of activities geared towards reading, speaking, listening, and writing you have used that really have changed the game in your classroom. Thank you so much for tuning in. I appreciate all your likes and your comments. Please keep them coming. They really do help me a lot. And I will see you next week for another tip on resources, strategies to meet the need of your English language learners. Thank you, and I'll see you next week.